to enjoy this special program that we have tonight. I've been the minister of music here for 5 years. I've been blessed to be out here at May for 5 years. And a little more than 3 years ago, we were in a transition. We were looking for a piano player for our praise team. And so we advertised for it. We put up flyers. We put some messages at the music stores and put out some word. And we waited for a long time. And I got to the point where I was almost ready to give up hope that we were going to find somebody to come and play piano for us. And then I was in my office one afternoon and I got a phone call from a soft-spoken young man. Hadn't ever met this person. Said, "Hello, my name is Abe. I was calling about the piano playing position at May First Baptist." Said, "Sure, come on by my office." And then about half an hour later, this person walked into my office, a little more than 6 feet tall.
6'3".
Big afro, hairdo. I was like, "Whoa, okay, we'll give it a try." And that next Sunday, Abe Cooper came to play and his family was here. And little did I know at that time that we were getting so much more than just a piano player.
That's right.
Abe Cooper and his brother Vic have been coming and sharing their talents and worshiping with us, leading us in worship, and sharing their passion to worship God with us here at May First Baptist. And they're part of our family and the whole Cooper family. We've just been so blessed by you guys. And so a few weeks ago, I had at least two different people come to me and say, "Why don't we have a concert with the Cooper brothers playing some gospel music?" I said, "Okay." I asked Abe about it, and like that, he had this ready to go. It was like he was waiting for the go to make this happen. And so we're here tonight to celebrate their talent, their passion for playing music that serves the Lord, that worships the Lord. And tonight, as you join us, if you feel like singing along in worship, we're going to have the words on the screen. Feel free to sing along. You're going to know a lot of these songs, and you're going to enjoy the music. We also have some special guests. Abe and Vic invited some of their friends. Brendan and Adriana are here from Howard Payne, some very talented vocalists, to join us tonight as well. And your own vocal talents will be added to the mix as you feel free to worship God tonight. So thank you for being here. Yes?
Just have Lee, Vic's mother, stand up and pronounce his full name that he wants us to call him. What is Vic's full name? We
Vic's
could
full
not
name.
Pronounce it.
I can pronounce it, but I'll let you.
Oh.
You
pronounce
Victoriano.
It. Yes.
Full name.
Victoriano.
What's, okay. Wait, I don't know the middle name.
You missed it, Mike.
I missed it. I'm going to bring the microphone back there. You better pipe down. Okay. Well, in any case, Abe and Vic, that's what we're going to call you, out here in May, Texas. We are so glad to have you here tonight. And I'm just going to start with a word of prayer, and then we're going to get right into the music. Lord, we just are so thankful this evening for this place for us to gather together as Christian brothers and sisters. Wherever we come from, God, we know who our Father is. We thank you so much for the musical talents of these young men that are part of our congregation here that have been worshiping with us each week. And we just thank you for their talent, their willingness, their spirit, and their heart to share these talents with us. God, I just ask that you would be praised tonight. Whatever greatness that we see in the talents of these musicians, that we would give that glory to you. I know that that's what the Cougars actually want to happen tonight. So God, we just worship you in this place. We honor you. Ask that you would bind us together in our hearts and our minds, and thank you for calling us out as your holy church. As the music plays, Lord, we lift your name high. We thank you, we praise you, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Give it up for Abe and Vic Cooper.
Thank you.
Harvey Brumley in 1929 at the age of 24. He was a gospel writer, and his inspiration to write Off My Way came from a secular song called The Prisoner's Song. And next, we will be playing Christ Alone, composed by Keith Getty in 2001.
Thank you.
by Charles Austin Miles in 1912 at the age of 44. He was a former pharmacist who became a gospel singer, and he was inspired during a cold, dreary day while thinking about walking in the garden with Jesus. We will walk through some cold, dreary days. There is a place in God's garden, and we can walk there where He walks, and we can talk with us, and He calls us His own. But now I introduce you to special guests from the Howard Payne University Heritage Singers Ensemble, Brendan Porter on bass and Andriana Rosenquist on soprano. And we will be performing the song Total Praise.
During his life, he had a debilitating stroke that paralyzed him.
faith in God during this time, praying and reading God's word, and struggling with the physical affliction of being paralyzed. And though he was still in this rough time, he looked toward the eternal victory he knew he would have as he approached sin. The song Victory in Jesus was born in the last years of his life, as God was able to give him one more song to share with the world. Horatio Spafford in 1876 at the age of 48. He wrote this after several traumatic events in his life. First, it was the death of his son at the age of 2. Then the Great Chicago Fire, 1871. And finally, what sent him over the edge was the death of all four of his daughters among a sinking ship. And even though he was trying through the fire, like the three Hebrew boys, he knew it was well with his soul through his faith in God.
Sing on to the Lord, a new song.
beautiful music. So now we're going to change the pace up a little bit. This is still a gospel song, but the name of it is Rise Again. It was composed in 1977 by Dallas Fulton.
Keep me in the ground.
so far. The Coopers are going to do just a couple more songs, but I wanted to share a little bit with you about the second purpose of this evening. We at May First Baptist are right in the middle of an expansion to our fellowship hall, Sunday school rooms, and this evening is part of a fundraiser for our building project. So far, we're entirely debt-free, and I'm telling you, these old guys that are building this thing can't work. I worked with them on Friday, and they wore me out. And so they are working hard to get this thing done. After the service, so after the music is finished tonight, we're going to have a fellowship with some cookies and coffee and stuff in the fellowship hall. And if you'd like to take a walk out and see the work on the expansion, you're welcome to do that. After we pray here, we're going to have the gentleman come forward. We're going to have the pass around the offering plates. And if you feel led to give, the money this evening is going to go directly toward finishing off our building project here. And so we ask that you would just open up your hearts to that and be generous as you feel called. So I'm going to have the gentleman come forward to go ahead and take the offering. As they play their last two songs, I just ask that you would enjoy the music. We'll look forward to fellowship after the music is over, and we'll go home from here. So thank you. Join me in prayer. Holy Father, we thank you this evening for the gift of music. We thank you so much for how you touch our hearts, and we feel your presence here as we worship you in song. God, I ask that you would bless this offering tonight for those who feel called to give to this building program. Lord, here at May First Baptist, we've seen the evidence of your great work. We have seen you move in so many awesome ways. And Lord, we're asking you to do something bigger than us here in this place. Your word promises that when we call on you and we honor you in this place, that you'll put your name here on this place forever. And that's what we want. So that when we're long gone, our children, our children's children, and strangers who we'll never meet will gather in this place to study your word, your holy word that never changes. That's what this is about, God. So we ask that you would receive these offerings and give us the wisdom to apply the funds to finishing off this building project and to see it through to completion to your glory, God. We thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Thank you.
that I want everyone to stand up, to clap and sing with us. I Saw the Light by Hank Williams.
is singing. Where we meet on Sunday night and we sing praises to our God. And I want to thank the Cooper brothers. I've never known two young men that were more eager to serve and give of the talents God has given them. I think they get it from their parents and pour their lives out for our community in Brownwood. And we're thankful for the Cooper family. Hey, if you didn't get enough, next Sunday, 11 o'clock, they'll be up here leading us. We'll be glad to have you, Tom. Again, thank you so much for being part of this night. Our God is able and our God is worthy. And we sang praises to Him tonight. And thank you so much for being here. We'll have a final prayer. Then remember, you'll go over to the fellowship hall and have some refreshments. We'll open up the door so you can get into our new addition. Be very careful that you don't fall over anything out there. You know, as men, we don't clean up after ourselves. So you're welcome to come see what we're doing. Let's pray. Father, it's been a good day to be in your house.